This right here is really one of my grail watches. Hello, welcome to the channel, welcome to Swiss Watch King. It's a new year and it's really a pleasure to start the year off with a banger. Today we're gonna review a watch which has been on my wish list for many, many years. A brand which I dearly love, one of the first brands I discovered when I tapped into this world of watchmaking. Today we're gonna review the beautiful Vacheron Constantin 1955 Comte des Vaches. Vacheron Constantin is one of the brands, like I said, which is really dear to me. When I remember reading about watches in my first year, I remember seeing the Malte Tourbillon, I remember seeing the 1921 American, and still today, the 1921 is one of the watches I will definitely own one day. I recently got to try on the smaller version of the white gold piece. It's just stunning, it fits my wrist, so definitely Vacheron, I'll be seeing you soon. This watch was lent to me by the Zurich boutique of Vacheron Constantin, and I especially have to thank Navid for helping me out. Vacheron is known to be in the holy trinity of watchmaking. The holy trinity consists of Audemars Piguet, Vacheron Constantin, and Patek Philippe. If you ask me which Vacheron I would buy, I would go for something like the Comte des Vaches, or the 1921, or maybe something like the Asymmetrique, or maybe the Prestige de la Paris, the 1972 models. The cases are out of the ordinary, and that's what I really like about Vacheron. Also, the movement is well finished, as is the dial. The Comte des Vaches is part of the historic line at Vacheron Constantin. Part of that line are also the Triple Calendar, the 1921 American, and also the Ultra Fine, which is a very thin watch, only 4.13 millimeters, with a beautiful hand-wound movement. Vacheron has been making watches since 1755, and it's been an uninterrupted journey for them. You know that I love cow horn lugs, or Comte des Vaches, like these are called. I own a beautiful Longines with a salmon dial, also a Pierce watch, which is a vintage piece. And also, I think the Jacob & Co Epic X, which I own, also has, like I like to say, modern Comte des Vaches lugs. The cowhorn lugs is really something you either like or you dislike. For me personally, I don't like them, I love them. Like I said, this is something that I look in a watch, something special. Something that might not appeal to everybody, but definitely speaks to me. The lugs are exquisitely made, well-shaped and curved. They're polished and actually they're welded on the case and then the residual material is taken off and polished. Basically, it looks like it's seamlessly attached to the case. A very beautiful execution by Vacheron Constantin and definitely one of the better ones I've seen. The rest of the case is polished from all sides. We have a very small bezel which is then curved downwards and we have the sapphire crystal on top of it. On the side, we have vintage inspired pump pushers. This watch pays tribute to the reference 6087, the manual winding chronograph, which was the first water-resistant chronograph manufactured by Vacheron Constantin. We have vintage inspired pushers on the side here at 2 and 4 o'clock. These are used to engage the chronograph seconds hand, which is now still. It is this blued steel long central seconds hand, and once you push the button at 2 o'clock, it's gonna start running. It's a very nice feeling when you push the chronograph, sturdy, not too soft, not too harsh. And then if you want to stop it, you again press the pusher at 2 o'clock and you reset it with the pusher at 4 o'clock. Very smooth operation here. We have a sub-dial for the minutes here, which is also with a blued hand. So you see the chronograph function is easily detectable with blue hands. So we have both heat-blued hands here and the sub-dial at 9 o'clock is actually for the running time seconds hand. The sub-dials are both sunken in and I love the symmetry of the whole dial. I really like that they didn't push like a date window here or something stupid like that. And also that the dial is very sleek and just clean. We have the applied Vacheron Constantin logo at 12 o'clock, applied indexes and also very beautifully polished hands. All the hands that you see here are not like silver or coated with something. They're actually white gold hands and highly polished. Except for the blued hands, those are made of steel. The dial is called silvered opaline dial. It resembles a nice eggshell color or maybe beige, depends how the light hits it. But the minute track for the time indication is in white and also it has these red printed numerals on them. On the periphery of the dial, we have the tachymeter scale for the chronograph function. The tachymeter scale basically tells you what the average speed was over a certain distance. Although the front side is gorgeous and the lugs stand out, the magic also happens when you turn the watch around. It's something very intimate and this is something I really look into a watch, a nicely finished movement. I currently own only one chronograph watch, it's the Alain Silberstein Louis Erard collaboration with a nice mono pusher movement. I didn't buy a high-end chronograph yet because I'm waiting for the right time, also because of the business I have. But if I would have the money to buy one, the Vacheron Constantin Corne de Vache and also the Langenjoner 1815 chronograph would be very tight contestants. In the past, I said that the best watch would be a Vacheron Constantin Corne de Vache with the Langenjoner 1815 movement because I love the German silver. But having this watch for a few days now, really taking it under the loop, I have to retract my statement. I would leave this watch as is. The movement is beautifully finished, Geneva hallmark, we have Côte de Geneva on the bridges, all the screw heads are polished, we've got a column wheel chronograph of course, and on top of the column wheel there's a mirror polished Maltese cross, which is of course in line with the Vacheron Constantin logo. The Maltese cross, as we saw, is also on the dial as well as on the crown. The caliber 1142 is based on the Lemania 2310 from the 1940s, which is also used as the Omega 321 movement. The movement was used also by Patek Philippe, Breguet and Roger Dubuis. It has a total of 146 components, again all beautifully finished. It features 48 hours of power reserve and beats at 3 Hz, so 21,600 vibrations per hour. I also like to just activate and deactivate the chronograph, and to see all the components and the clutch move in harmony and just make all of this mechanical magic happen. Again, you start, stop, and then you reset and it jumps back. The movement also features a free sprung balance wheel, which you can finally adjust to chronometer standards. Again, this is the sign of high-end watchmaking. A lot of adjustments are possible, the finishing is exquisite, and really, there's so many details to be discovered once you take the loop in your hand and just take a closer look at it. Let me now put the watch on the wrist and show you how it fits me. This model features a pin buckle with a Maltese cross, also in stainless steel, beautifully polished. I love how this looks, by the way. And the strap is very well made as well. The Fiume strap is made in Milan by a company called Serapian. They've been producing leather goods since 1928. And you really see that Vacheron Constantin tries to work with the best people they can find. You see the side of the profile is very slim. This watch is only 10.9 millimeters thin, and when I turn the wrist around, you can see how it fits me. I've got an 18.1 centimeter wrist size, and this 38.5 millimeter case suits me just perfectly. Lock to lock, we have 47.8 millimeters, and I think smaller wrists can wear this watch because they're curved downwards. Again, wearing a classical watch, a dress watch, doesn't have to be 41, 42, 45 millimeters. 38.5, I think, is a perfect size. I own many smaller watches and I got used to them. And also, I think it's more comfortable to wear most of the time. If you want to buy this model, which I think is definitely worth it, considering the hype on the market with other chronographs from other brands which are not finished to this level, the price in Swiss francs is 43,800. There's also a rose gold version available for 59,000 Swiss francs, and the platinum version is discontinued, you can't order it anymore, but it was also a beautiful piece. This one was available for 74,000 Swiss francs. Again, stainless steel for me, because I also often don't care about the case material, because it just pushes up the price, but that's again a personal choice of mine. This is definitely the model I would choose. Let me know in the comment section below which Vacheron Constantin are you considering to purchase for yourself, what's your favorite one, or maybe just how you like this watch in particular. This was the first review of the year, I hope you liked it, share this video and also subscribe. We will create many cool videos this year, I promise you. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you next week with a very fun video.